So I hope you remember that a couple of weeks ago, I posted a video about things to talk about on a first date. And I did that because many times the reasons a first date ends badly or there is no second date is people try to get into information and sharing ideas before the relationship is really even a relationship, before the couple has time to kind of get to know each other. Today, I want to give you topics that are appropriate for second, third, and fourth dates. And I think taking your time with these and really exploring each of them are important. These are noted in the American Psychological Association as being dating questions for healthy relationships or dating concepts for healthy relationships. And that's why I'm going with these, because I like everything I do to fit into the auspice or under the umbrella of what we know in marriage research is the most helpful for couples. So a great thing to do is talk about on the second date your passions. What kind of things really turn you on? What do you see yourself doing? What did you notice from an early childhood? The kind of things that always interested you. You want to go deeper. Like, you can stay up talking about it and thinking about it and researching it forever. When couples share this, it really helps them identify similarities as well as differences. And it also begins the making of respecting your partner, which is so important in a long-term healthy relationship. Secondly, religion and politics. These are hot topics. And the reason I ask you to talk about them the second date is because after the first date, you know this is a person that you're comfortable with, that you actually wanted a second date. With each of these things, what you're looking for is that the person is not so much agreeing with you, but accepting of what your values are in each of these. So, like, what religion were you raised in? Is that religion still part of your life? Are you working on any projects now in your religion? Things such as, do you attend services? Is it a big part of you? What political party do you identify? And what makes that important for you? I think questions like that are going to help open it up and make it more understandable so that you can evaluate better if there's a commonality between the two of you that you actually can build on. Secondly, I think entertainment, sharing entertainment, tells you what your partner does as far as relaxing or where they draw energy. Because most of us, what we use for entertainment, we're actually getting restored or refueled, or we relax in that. And that's why that's really important. So things like, what was the last book you read and really got into? What TV series do you keep coming back to and rewatching? What was the last show you binge watched? What are the favorite apps on your phone? What are your favorite podcasts? When you ask these questions, I think it gives you a really good idea, and you might want to explore some of them yourself, of what your partner is being influenced by. I think talking about career and lifestyle choices is so important. And that goes in the second date also. So you can see the second, third, and fourth date, you're going to pace these out. You probably won't go through all of these on a second date, but as you pace them, you can start feeling better about them. So I think the questions of career and lifestyle, you're trying to get at the bottom of what they feel about where they're going in their career. Do they feel like they're at the pinnacle of their career? Do they feel like they can do more? Did they get trained in something that they want to explore other options? Are they what I call someone who grows into the profession? How ambitious are they? Do they see their career taking over their lifestyle? Do they see their career as moving them? What's most important to them? career or family, and how do they think they would balance those two? Questions like that are really going to help you when you're identifying how this person sees themselves. Some people live for their career. They love their career. Others want a career, but they'll be ready to put it on the shelf when the kids come along. They don't want their career interfering with the kids. And I think that's very important to know up front. When we talk about anything with passion, I think it's important that you understand too that passion is more than what turns a person on. It's what actually like lights them inside. So if you ask questions about, are you working on any passion projects now? You're going to get an idea. Is this person a global person? Is this person liking nonprofits? Does this person want to get involved in saving the world? Or is there a specific niche that they're into? What are your favorite ways to spend free time? Who is the most fascinating person you've met? This gives you a lot of insight. What hobbies would you get into if you had unlimited time and money? This will tell you so much about the person, where they want to live, how they want to live. It's building a little story for them, if you will. What new skills have you learned or activities have you done since the pandemic started? And I find that one especially important with my pre-married couples who are getting ready now, but exploring this option even more because we may be living in this time for the next year at least. What are you always game to do? Like, what would you drop at the sound of a hat to go do? That is a true passion. And lastly, what is the most spontaneous thing you've ever done? You kind of get an idea of, does this person like surprises? Does this person like spontaneity? Is this person more meticulous? Are they more self-disciplined? Do they have a plan? Do they like privacy before you surprise them with something? So these are all second, third, and fourth date questions. At any point within the first 6 dates, if you see any red flags, I would still be very alert and I would still trust my gut.